I'm going to talk about the white paper from a perspective of an educator from the Centre of Asian Studies. I do concur with what Greg has been saying, that actually as an educator it is pleasing to see that the white paper sees the importance of the role education plays in Australia in the Asian century. In particular, the white paper recognises the urgent need to develop detailed strategies for students of Asia and Asian languages as a core component to train Asia-capable workforce, leaders and institutions. From the educator's perspective, however, the five pathways for higher education sector to lead the country to 2025 are somewhat culturally underdeveloped. What is missing is a culturally sophisticated approach based on educational research in an already globalized environment. These pathways in the white paper should be, first and foremost, grounded in the more transcultural vision, what I called. Asia is rising and changing the world in the process of its rise. The bilateral and multilateral relationships with Asia and Asian countries are rapidly changing the cultural and social dynamics of both Australia and Asia. It is of crucial significance that the higher education sector, policymakers and educators inclusive, appreciate the importance that higher education institutions are no longer teaching Australians' next generation of workforce to be just Asian literate alone. Rather, as an already highly globalized sector, the education happens both ways, involving a transcultural flow of knowledge. The white paper talks about educating Asia-capable leaders. This process presumably denotes the teaching of next generation Australians to be Asian literate for the transnational workforce. However, in the multicultural and globalized institutions, Australian higher education sector has long been training Asia-capable leaders like Singaporean 5th President and 7th President, respectively, that graduates from Adelaide University. And also Shi Guangrong, who was the 2005 number one richest man in China, was trained in the University of New South Wales. Australian higher education has been globalized and entered into the third wave, and its vision for the 2025 has to reflect the effect of this globalization. Educating global citizens both in Australia and from Asia. In 2009, more than 20% of tertiary students studying in Australia were international students, and the majority of them were from Asia. With over 1 in 5 students on campus from different cultural backgrounds, Australian higher education urgently needs to address the implications of diversity in students' population and embrace a transcultural perspective in that education is no longer a single-dimensional, one-way flow of knowledge. As its mission, Australian higher education should be, and already is, teaching Asia-capable leaders in Australia and from Asia. More broadly, transcultural and transnational workforce. Educators and the policymakers in Australia higher education could learn from the Confucian philosophy of education that, first of all, everyone equally has the capacity to be educated. And secondly, everyone equally has the right to be educated. In Chinese, we call that 有教无类, which is in that book, this notion. Translated into the Australian context, it will mean that all students on campus, regardless of where they come from, are educatable and should be granted the right of equal access to quality education. Our current policies and pedagogies in practice cast doubt on the educatability of international students, as they are automatically remedial by definition of their specific cultural and linguistic backgrounds. In addition, the current defined graduate attributes with which we have been working on in the university very often are inappropriate to the specific needs of these international students and fail to take into account what these students bring to their learning context. A progressive pedagogy and curriculum that capitalizes on Asian international students' multilingual competency and offers them equal access to education that prepares them for their transnational futures is crucial to ensure the mission of producing Asia-capable leaders in Australia and from Asia. Failing to transform the current policies, pedagogies, to recognize that everyone is both educatable and has the right to quality education, and to educate students from the transcultural, transnational life they're going to lead, can only generate negative learning experiences for the future Asia-capable leaders from Asia. For example, cognitive researchers have shown that critical thinking is not a skill that can be acquired and deployed irrespective of content. Background knowledge is necessary to engage in critical thinking. The current defined graduate attributes of this university and many other universities for social sciences and humanities departments tend to essentialize the Aristotelian logic and a particular type of critical thinking. Such homogenized learning imperatives, researchers have found, alienate Asian international students, negatively affect their university experiences due to their anxiety in the linguistic and cultural dislocation, and disproportionately discriminate these students in terms of the measurements of academic achievements. In one of the classes I taught, where there were all third year students from Commerce, they came to our department to do research project course. I've studied their academic transcript background. Their GPA average is 3.5. In other words, they were actually passing the university experience with a pass, 50% all the way through before they came to us. And lots of them were very intelligent and speak very good English at the same time. Now, to conclude, Australia's capacity in reforming the higher education system not only will determine how Asia-ready Australia will be in 2025, but also how prosperous Australia will be in 2025. The five pathways for education, for higher education to lead the country to the future should be grounded in and fully embrace a new educational paradigm which takes into account of the transcultural flows of knowledge on campus. The white paper should mark a turning point for Australian higher education, a mindset shift that will enable Australians to fully engage and emerge within the Australian community in the Asian century.